inserted in the conversation booklet. We'll sing verses 1, 2, and 3 of our opening hymn. Take down your cross, the Savior said, if you would my disciple be, take up your cross with willing heart and humbly follow after me. Take up your cross, let it not its way, fill your weak spirit with thy love, its strength shall bear your spirit up, and embrace your heart and gird your arm. Take up your cross, heed not the shame, and let your foolish pride be still. Jesus, please see you in the garden, praying in the darkness of night. Your anguish and prayer is one of deep struggle with the Father's will. While you agonize over the Father's will and are strengthened to fulfill his plan, your disciples, overcome with sadness, can do nothing but give themselves over to sleep. As we begin this journey with you, Jesus, help us to see that for you it was a journey of love. May we learn from this walk how to follow you more closely and accept the love that you have for us. Lord Jesus, pray us for mercy. Help us to face life's difficulties honestly, knowing that we can trust in God. Strengthen us in the time of our trials. May our prayer always be an expression of all that we are and all that we do. We love you, Jesus. Teach us how to pray. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
The second station, Jesus is betrayed and arrested. We praise you, Jesus, and give you thanks.
By your cross and resurrection, you have set us free.
A reading from the Gospel of Mark. Immediately, while Jesus was still speaking, Judas, one of the 12, arrived, and with him there was a crowd with swords and clubs from the chief priests, the scribes, and the elders. Now the betrayer had given them a sign, saying, "The one I will kiss is the man. Arrest him and lead him away under guard." So when he came, he went up to him at once and said, "Rabbi," and kissed him. Then they laid hands on him and arrested him.
Jesus, as you wait your disciples, one who has not slept arise with an angry crowd. Judas reveals your identity to them with a kiss. His act of affection is a signal to point you out as the one who loves but is rejected by his own.
Lord Jesus, we are quick to greet you with affection in our prayer and worship. But how often do our external words and actions conceal hearts that are easily turned from you? We love you, Jesus. Help us to love you with all our hearts.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ,
Jesus was silent. Then the high priest said to him, I put you under oath before the living God. Tell us if you are the Messiah, the Son of God. Jesus said to him, You have said so, but I tell you, from now on you will see the Son of Man seated at the right hand of power and coming on the clouds of heaven. Then the high priest tore his clothes and said, He has blasphemed. Why do we still need witnesses? You have now heard his blasphemy. What is your verdict? They answered, He deserves death.
Jesus, your words are blasphemy to the ears of the high priest. He tears his garments, unable to see the presence of God and the one who stands before him arrested and accused. He cannot believe in a God who he calls of such great love would willingly become so powerless.
And with Jesus, we can be our mission. We find it difficult to look beyond our narrow expectations and see that as you are. Give us the grace to hear your words clearly and to follow you in the truth. We love you, Jesus, reveal to us what God is like.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
The fourth station, Peter denies knowing Jesus. We praise you, Jesus, and give you thanks.
A reading from the Gospel of Matthew. Now Peter was sitting outside in the courtyard. A servant girl came to him and said, You also were with Jesus of Galilee. But he denied it before all of them, saying, I do not know what you are talking about. When he went out to the porch, another servant girl saw him, and she said to the bystanders, This man was with Jesus of Nazareth. Again he denied it with an oath, I do not know the man. After a little while, the bystanders came up and said to Peter, Certainly you are also one of them, for your accent betrays you. Then he began to curse, and he swore an oath, I do not know the man. At that moment, the cock crowed. Then Peter remembered what Jesus had said, Before the cock crows, you will deny me 3 times. And he went out and wept bitterly.
Jesus, you told Peter that he would deny you 3 times before the cock would crow. He did not believe you. He swore that he would never deny you, and that in fact he was willing to die for you. Peter felt that he knew himself better than you knew him, but as the dawn approaches and the cock crows, he sees the truth.
Jesus, you know, I follow you, but then quickly turn, going our way. We are afraid to acknowledge you in front of others. But you speak to us in the midst of our time. We love you, Jesus. Keep us faithful to you.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
The fifth station, Jesus is condemned by Pilate. We praise you, Jesus, and give you thanks.
By your cross and resurrection, you have set us free.
A reading from the Gospel of Luke. Pilate then called together with the chief priests, the leaders, and the people, and said to them, You brought me this man as one who was perverting the people. And here I have examined him in your presence, and have not found this man guilty of any of your charges against him. Neither has Herod, for he has sent him back to us. Indeed, he has done nothing to deserve death. But they kept urgently demanding with loud shouts that he be crucified, and their voices prevailed. So Pilate gave his verdict that their demand should be granted.
Jesus. Jesus, Pilate perceives your innocence, but the crowd insists on guilt. Hearing your persistent shouts, Pilate sets aside the judgment of his conscience, and the decision is made. He hands you over to be crucified.
When Jesus called him to death, the threatening voice of the crowd, but the rumble voice of conscience, fill us with compassion for the outcast, committed to the truth. We love you, Jesus, the unseen on the crowd.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
The sixth station. Jesus is scourged and crowned with thorns. We praise you, Jesus, and give you thanks.
For your cross and resurrection, give us that security.
Jesus, soldiers of earthly realm mock your kingship. You are so powerless and their eyes so weak, the ruler of a kingdom that cannot be seen and therefore must not exist. They treat you as a foolish imposter caught in a lie.
O Jesus, how often do we look for a kingdom with the eyes of the world rather than the eyes of faith? We forget your promise that your kingdom is among us. Help us to see your strength and our weakness, your reign and our powerlessness. We love you, Jesus, establish your rule over us.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
The seventh station, Jesus takes up his cross. We praise you, Jesus, and give you thanks.
By your cross and resurrection, you have set us free.
Jesus, like Isaac carrying the wood to the mountain, you set out with the wood of the cross. But unlike him, you will not ask your father where the lamb is, because you know you are the lamb of the sacrifice. You now begin your journey with the cross.
O Jesus, if you carry the cross, which is given unjustly, you willingly bear the burden of our sinfulness and accept the cross of our guilt. There is no greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. We love you, Jesus. Help us to show this love in our lives.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
The eighth station, Simon the Cyrene, helps Jesus. We praise you, Jesus, and give you thanks.
By your cross and resurrection, you have set us free.
A reading from the Gospel of Luke. As they led him away, they seized a man, Simon of Cyrene, who was coming from the country, and they laid the cross on him and made him carry it behind Jesus.
Jesus, the torture you experienced at the hands of the soldiers left you weak. When you prayed in the garden that the will of the Father be done, an angel was sent to strengthen you. Now, as you seek to fulfill the Father's will, he sends Simon to help you.
Lord Jesus, strengthen us in our journey. Open our hearts to the help you offer through the kindness of others. Open our eyes to the needs of those who walk beside us. We love you, Jesus, lighten our burdens.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
The ninth station, Jesus meets the weeping women. We praise you, Jesus, and give you thanks.
By your cross and resurrection, you have set us free.
A reading from the Gospel of Luke. A great number of people followed him, and among them were women who were beating their breasts and wailing for him. But Jesus turned to them and said, "Daughters of Jerusalem, do not weep for me, but weep for yourselves and your children. For the great days are surely coming when they will say, 'Blessed are the barren, and the wombs that never bore, and the breasts that never nursed.' Then they will begin to say to the mountains, 'Fall on us,' and to the hills, 'Cover us.' For if they do this when the wood is green, what will happen when it is dry?"
Jesus, after being silent, you speak. You turn the eyes of the women away from your suffering and toward the destructive powers of sin. You warn them not to shed their tears for you, but rather for themselves and their children. If you, the innocent one, can suffer so, what will be the fate of the guilty?
But Jesus, the wood is now in great trial. Set fire to the world so that it might burn with your love. Destroy all hatred, fill us with joy again. Teach us to mourn the way things are. Show us the way they could be. We love you, Jesus. Lead before us.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
The tenth station, Jesus is crucified. We praise you, Jesus, and give you thanks.
By your cross and resurrection, you have set us free.
A reading from the Gospel of Luke. When they came to the place that is called the Skull, they crucified Jesus there with the criminals, one on his right and one on his left. Then Jesus said, "Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing." And they cast lots to divide his clothing. And the people stood by watching. But the leaders scoffed at him, saying, "He saved others, let him save himself, if he is the Messiah of God, his chosen one." The soldiers also mocked him, coming up and offering him sour wine and saying, "If you are the King of the Jews, save yourself." There was also an inscription over him, "This is the King of the Jews."
Jesus, your suffering continues as nails are driven into your hands and feet, and taunting jeers are hurled at your body, imprisoned on the cross. Yet to those who mock and challenge you, you offer no reproach, only forgiveness and compassion for them in their ignorance.
Oh, Jesus, how often we have acted as if the way of the cross were unnecessary and too difficult. We believe we know a better way, a way worn down by the crowd. We find that path goes nowhere. Forgive us. We do not know what we are doing. We love you, Jesus. Allow your wounds to heal us.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
The 11th station, Jesus promises paradise to the crucified thief. We praise you, Jesus, and give you thanks.
By your cross and resurrection, you have set us free.
A reading from the Gospel of Luke. One of the criminals who was hanged there kept deriding Jesus, saying,
we deserve for our deeds. But this man has done nothing wrong. Then he said, Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom. Jesus replied, truly I tell you, today you will be with me in paradise.
Jesus, two others are nailed on either side of you. One challenges you to release him, while the other asks to be free with you in your kingdom. One sees only weakness, the other sees power, and is able to trust in a promise of everlasting life with you as his time in this world comes to an end.
Lord Jesus, look upon us now. See us in our need, and hear us as we cry out to you. Help us to trust you in difficult circumstances. Give us eyes to see your power in hopeless times, to see your kingdom in all we encounter. We love you, Jesus. Remember us.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
The 12th station, Jesus cares for his mother. We praise you, Jesus, and give you thanks.
For your cross and resurrection, make us set us free.
A reading from the Gospel of John. Standing near the cross of Jesus were his mother and his mother's sister, Mary, the wife of Clopas, and Mary Magdalene. When Jesus saw his mother and the disciple whom he loved standing beside her, he said to his mother, Woman, here is your son. Then he said to the disciple, Here is your mother. And from that hour, the disciple took her into his own home.
Jesus, you give your mother to the disciple you love. Even as you face death, you trust those whom you love most into each other's care. Your dying is marked by giving and by concern for the ones who remain. You do not leave us as orphans. You have promised your spirit to your church, and at the cross the church is born.
O Jesus, promise to you that we are the disciples you love, and you can bear your mother to us too. We pray that we might allow the spirit to give us life as sisters and brothers joined in mutual care. We love you, Jesus, bind us as one.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
The 13th station, Jesus dies. We praise you, Jesus, and give you thanks.
Lord, the cross of resurrection, you have set us free.
A reading from the Gospel of Luke. It was now about noon, and darkness came over the whole land until 3 in the afternoon, while the sun's light failed, and the curtain of the temple was torn in two. Then Jesus, crying with a loud voice, said, Father, into your hands I commend my spirit. Having said this, he breathed his last. When the centurion saw what had taken place, he praised God and said, Certainly this man was innocent.
Jesus, the word spoken by the Father, you now return to him, having accomplished the purpose for which you were sent. Your trust in the Father remains, even amid the dark times of death.
O Jesus, enable us to accomplish the purpose for which we were created. Help us to commit ourselves into the Father's hands, to trust in him, and believe his love for us, the love that your death reveals to us, neither dying ever be in vain. We love you, Jesus. Help us to die to ourselves and live for you.
Lord, have have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
The 14th station, Jesus is buried. We praise you, Jesus, and give you thanks.
By your cross and resurrection, you have set us free.
Our reading from the Gospel of Luke. Then Joseph of Arimathea took the body of Jesus down, wrapped it in a linen cloth, and laid it in a rock-hewn tomb where no one had ever been laid. It was a day of preparation, and the Sabbath was beginning. The woman who had come with him from Galilee followed, and they saw the tomb and how his body was laid. Then they returned and prepared spices and ointments. On the Sabbath day they rested according to the commandment.
Jesus, now the time of surrender of being at rest begins. It is the seventh day that God rested from the work of creation. And you, the Son of God, rest and await the dawn of the eighth day when all will be made new. And we wait with you.
O Jesus, teach us to rest. Deliver us from thinking that everything depends upon our actions. Help us to be patient in trusting that God will bring about the completion of his creation through you. We love you, Jesus. Fill us with your peace.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
A reading from the Gospel of John. When it was evening on that day, the first day of the week, the doors of a house where the disciples had met were locked for fear of the Jews. Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." After he said this, he showed them his hands and his side. Then the disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." Jesus, with joy we view your victorious wounds. Help us to meditate on them and to see in them a sign of victory. May they give us courage to go forth with your blessing.
O Jesus, bless us with your outstretched hands. Give us your peace. Give us your love. We love you, Jesus. Be with us as we go out to be loaded up.
The Lord be with you.
And with your
spirit. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. All of our readers for stations this year. Appreciate all of that. Make sure I get the tags back for next year. Our verses 4 and 5 of the closing song.